I know you wanna love, but I just wanna fuck. And yeah, you know the deal. You gotta keep it real. Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. How are y'all doing today? I am tired, okay. I didn't really get any sleep and it's like 8 in the morning and I was like, I'ma just film a video. I'm bored, I don't wanna sleep. Literally couldn't fucking sleep. And then I went to McDonald's and got fucking breakfast sandwich. That's what I always do when I can't sleep. I know this is random, but bitch, it hits so hard. I get the sausage egg biscuit with cheese. It's just so fucking good. I can't do it. Today I'm gonna be doing a bad bitch transformation, as I do. Full makeup transformation, hair, outfit, hopefully. I'm gonna show y'all how I be catfishing all these motherfuckers around me, because why I be looking under all this makeup, it don't add up sometimes. My room looks so cute right now. Hey, I'm looking on my TikTok for makeup inspiration because I need to do something different. Last night I did some cut crease with glitter, which was so pretty, and I might do something like that again because I didn't really get pictures in it or anything. I really didn't take pictures. I took some videos, but it went off. I did a full cut crease yesterday. I did like just my lid. So I think I'm gonna do like a whole like wing and then do winged eyeliner. What are we thinking about that? Drink your water, y'all, because what the fuck? It is so important to drink your water. But before we get started with this video, I'd like to give a huge shout out to our sponsor, Scentbird. Oh my god. Scentbird was like one of my big sponsors like junior year of high school, and they recently just reached out to me again, and I was like, oh my gosh, yes, I'd love to work with y'all again. Like, their whole website and service is so easy and convenient for cheap bitches like me, okay? If you don't know what Scentbird is, it's a fragrance subscription service that offers 600 luxurious brands. You can customize the amount of fragrances you want each month, or you could even skip the months you wanted. Through Scentbird, you can try all the high-end perfumes that you've been waiting to try for at least $16 a month. And if you use my code, which is Mackenzie, I'll just put it down here on the screen, also put it in the description box, you will get 30% off. So it'll only be $11 a month. They sent over 5 fragrances. I think these fragrance cards are definitely new. Whenever I worked with them last, I don't remember them having these nice cards. And it has just what the actual perfume looks like. All the ingredients, has a little paragraph that describes the perfume, all of that. There's a little QR code down the app. I got Estee Lauder Pleasures, the Sanctuary Vaquita Dolphin. One in particular is cruelty-free, vegan, and clean. It has like this little open envelope for this one. 1% of all the proceeds from this fragrance will support Save the Whales efforts to raise awareness about the critically endangered vaquita and further our shared mission to preserve and protect the ocean and its inhabitants. So this one's saving the dolphins, so make sure y'all go get this one. Got Soleil Lalique, I think that's how I say it. Michael Germain Paris Sugarful Dream. And then I got Confessions of a Rebel, Let's Be Real. Basically, the perfume just come in these little vials, and there's actually more perfume in here than you would think. It has over 200 sprays, I'm pretty sure. And it just comes like this, and then you just twist it, and then you literally just, and boom. And if you're not sure about a fragrance that you want to try, they also have a little mini quiz that you can fill out. And based on your preferences and your quiz answers, it'll choose a fragrance that you'll love. Something that's new, Scentbird is actually expanding to Canada. So if y'all are in Canada now, you can also get Scentbird, which is very exciting. Favorite are these two right here. Not sure which perfume is which, like if you get more than one. I was like, oh my god, which is which? You just pull out the vial. I'm done. This one's Lalique Soleil. And then this perfume is the Michael Germain Sugarful Dream. These ones are just, they're light, airy. They're not too harsh of a scent, but they're very like confident smelling. I really just love these. I'd have to say the Sugarful Dream. It just smells very sweet and I love my sweet fragrances. So like I said, if y'all want to go try Scentbird, I'm gonna have the link first thing in the description. Make sure y'all go download the app and also use my code Mackenzie to get 30% off your first month, okay? And let's just get started with the video. Every time I do Scentbird videos, I remember I would just be spraying these perfumes like nobody's business. And like, whew, it smells expensive in here now, I'm not gonna lie. Like, when do you ever find the time to like shop for luxurious perfumes, you know what I mean? Like, obviously you'll go into Victoria's Secret and you'll be like testing out the perfumes, but like, when are you gonna go to a Gucci and like try a Gucci perfume or go and try a Prada? Like, you can really only rely on like reviews. So like through Scentbird, like you can try it for way, way cheap. You can figure out what it smells like and if you really like it to buy the full bottle. I kind of want to listen to music. So we might just get copyrighted because I just really need some music right now. I think I'm going to make this a chit chat because I haven't done like a chit chat get rid of me in a minute. Well, I finally like went through all my classes and like figured out everything I need to do. So now I'm like stressing because I have homework, which is like, that's lame. Like, let me tell y'all, my first drawing assignment is to draw a portrait like of a selfie. I'm like, oh my god, can we start with something more simple? Like, you really just want to expose me? Like, I really hope we don't show the whole class this because I'm not good. And then like, here's the kicker, we're supposed to tape two pencils together and then draw a portrait of a selfie of us. I'm like, that's gonna look like shit. Can't draw. Like, I thought you were gonna teach us how to draw. He was like, I'm gonna teach you how to draw. Da-da-da. I mean I guess with drawing, like, the only way you can learn is like through just fucking like going for it. If y'all see glitter on my face, like, I literally washed my face like twice and I can't get this glitter off from last night. How are you still on my face? I don't get it. Yeah, I'm like, bro, I can't draw. Do you understand this? Don't spray all the perfumes at once, y'all. We're gonna freaking die. Crease and then put like a, hit the buttocks. Drinking them straight with no regrets. Honestly, I've got a problem. I like the taste. You're wasted with you. Tell me what's good for me, but I don't give. Shit, so high cost. Get booted off just to get lost. No love lost, no bridges burned. I live and learn, I learn from my hurt. Show me what I have been missing. I need to wet my sponge. I hate this, it's so far away. Do you come out better? I'm not sober, so you know how it's about to go. I like to fuck when I'm drunk. A little bit of prep. So I'm gonna use this Aquaphor, I got this little specifically for the lips. I always use Aquaphor anyways, but this one's specifically for the lips. I'm gonna be singing a lot right now because I just need to. Now I'm gonna use the Tula Skincare Rose Glow and Get It Cooling and Brightening Eye Balm because these eyes need some brightening. I can't believe I didn't sleep last night. Like, I have to stay up all day now. Oh, I hate that. Oh, that feels so nice. Wow. I do not use the products I have enough. Like, I have shit. Or even just like stuff that I get from like companies and stuff. And I just don't fucking use them. I don't know if you're supposed to use this before makeup, though. I don't know, but that shit feels amazing. Oh my god. I think I might do some story times in this, so y'all watch this. I'm gonna do some story times. Last night, my college, let me just get to do my freaking makeup before. So, I do my eyebrows first. I don't know about y'all, but fuck the makeup really. The key to catfishing and truly being a bad bitch, I'm not saying like I'm catfishing like that, you know, it's just like I'm more just being extra when it comes to saying catfish and shit, because you know I'm beautiful, you know what I mean, with or without makeup. Like with makeup, I think every girl feels like this whenever they wear makeup, like bitch, we don't need makeup, but when it's on though, you can't tell me shit. Like literally there's glitter everywhere, and then we use this like glitter like rollerball thing. I don't know, long story short, there's glitter everywhere. I was laying in my bed with my makeup on, like it's probably all over my pillows. I know y'all, I know. But what was I gonna say? Oh, last night my campus had I think they normally have it every year, but because of COVID, they didn't have it last year, so like I didn't get to experience it yet. And they had just like a, definitely made that way too thick. Yeah, that looks like shit. Last time my eyebrows looked so good, so I'm not expecting anything turning out good in my favor today. A glow party, and it's really all, everyone just like dresses in fucking white, and like the college hires an expensive ass DJ, and we were just on the field on campus here, and it was so fun. I was really channeling just like my rave self. I was just like jumping and shit. Which I'm not really like, I don't be like jumping up and down like, you know what I mean? But I was fucking feeling that shit. Like he was playing pretty good songs. Like it was good ass songs. I was not expecting that like at all. It was very fun. Kind of sad they didn't have one last year. Like that would have been fun, little freshman year moment, but. I'd have to say that's like one of my highlights from this school so far now. Very random, but I was like, I was wondering if I ever told y'all like my first kiss story time. So I'm just gonna do it. I don't know if I've ever told y'all how that was. I feel like I've told y'all about it before. I told y'all how I lost my virginity, but I don't remember. If I told y'all, I'm pretty sure I told, I don't know, but I'ma just do it. So, my first kiss happened last October, and it's really funny how it all played out. It all was the damn Tindy, okay? It was all the damn Tinder. And when I came down here for college, I never had Tinder. I never went on any dating sites. I never talked to anybody. Yeah, I never did that. And then I got here, my friends were like, we have Tinder, download it. And like, I was like, hell yeah, I'ma do that. So we get to swiping and one thing leads to another, and I feel like this is still a little bit of a fresh topic. Like I don't know if I should still be talking about this already so soon. I don't know, I feel like it's just a really close topic because it was so recent. It's not that recent now, but it just feels so recent. But Now that I look back on it, it was kind of like the cutest thing ever. I don't know. I don't have any weird, like, ill feelings towards him. I used to. I would be like, oh my god, he's a dick, but I don't know. I really don't have any feelings for this man. Like, negative feelings, you know what I mean? But basically, I was talking to this guy. I got to swipe it, and I swiped on this man. He said he was on the soccer team here. I was like, hey, Miss Thing. And we talked a couple days, like literally when I moved here. It was like right when I moved here. I feel like it was right when I moved here. Or like a couple weeks after I moved here. I think it was a couple weeks. And then we finally end up linking or whatever. And I think I told this story on here before already, but I was so nervous to go meet this man. So I was like, I made my roommate walk with me to where I was gonna meet him, cause we were meeting like at the middle of campus, like at 10 o'clock at night, 9 o'clock at night, to walk around campus. Like, what the what? Very funny. But my friends come with me, and then we pull up to the little place. He's like sitting down. My friends see him. I'm like, oh my god, this is so crazy. I'm like, oh my god, like, this is my first ever like time like being with a man like of like romantic interest, like alone, you know what I mean? So I was like, oh my god. I was like, Kenzie, who are you? I remember that night I was so flustered, like I was so shook. I was like, just remembering how I was feeling, and like I was walking home just like red cheeks. I was so like, oh my god, I just had my first kiss, like I just made out with him, honey. Like, we've come such a far. We've come such a long way. But let me continue. So I say bye to my friends. I'm like, bye. And they're like, if you need me, text me. And I'm like, yeah. So we start walking, and it was like, we made good conversation. We were just talking about our majors, what classes we were in. Mind you, I think he was a sophomore, I was a freshman. So we're just walking around, and I don't know if this is what like he always does. Like, guys are weird. But we end up walking to the soccer field, and there's like this brick like seating thing, and we end up sitting there, and like you can just look at the soccer field. It was just like the whole soccer field. It felt like, in the moment, I was like, I didn't even know what the fuck was about to happen. We just sat there. And, like, I still have the fucking, like, I still have, like, what he said, like, replaying in my head. Like, I can remember, like, exactly what he looked like when he asked it. It was such a middle school moment. Because, like, we sat down, and then he was like, do you want to make out? I was like, I felt like a whole like sixth grader. I feel like that's what sixth graders would do. Do you want to make out? I was like, and then he just pulled one of the, you know what I mean? He just started like going, he just went in. I was like, it was something. He was like, do you want to make out? And I was like, I sat there, I turned, I was like, I don't know. And then he just like, and I was like, And then he proceeds to stuff his tongue down my throat. I feel like this man has made me such like a tongue kisser now, because like that's all I know. Like, it's kind of gross thinking of it like that, you know? Let me take it back. But, yeah, he just, like, threw his tongue down my throat. And I was like, whoa, 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 whoa. I remember we kissed, and then I was like, wait. And then I drew back a little bit, and he was like, and I was like, okay. It was just so, I don't even know. It was so awkward. And, like, I really liked this man, too, when he literally was just, like, gave me no reason to. Like, it was just, like, my first, like, intimate kind of thing with a guy. So I was like, oh, my God, he likes me. And, yeah, like, each time we linked after that, I was like, oh, my God, we're in love. Like, no. Not how that works around here. Baby girl. Yeah, that was my first kiss. Like, my first. And then, oh my God. So, after that happened, we, like, got up. And we walked, like, near our, like, university center. Oh my God. I can't believe I'm exposing myself like that. But why the fuck not? So, we walked, like, by. And it was, like, a bench. Like, right by the university center. I feel like anyone could have saw. But it was so late. I was like, whatever. So, we sat on the bench. And we were just, like, looking at the stars. I don't even fucking remember. Talking about astrology. Or it was on a full moon. I was like, it's a full moon or something. And then he just, like, put his hand on my shirt. And I was like, oh, my God. And then he was playing with my boobs. I was like, is this really what the girl you'd be doing? I was like, is this what it is? It was just such an awkward, like, first experience. Like, honestly, I got here and I was like, I'm sick of the shenanigans. Like, what the fuck? Who am I kissing? Who, what are we doing? Like, I was like, let's just fucking get it over with. Because, I mean, I'm all about waiting for the right person. But, you know, sometimes you just want to do it. So I was like, I'm sick of it. I really don't think it's going to be like that. So, you know what I mean? So I just, whatever. Be like that sometimes, okay? It does. And then he fucking grabbed my throat. I was like, whoa. He like pulled back and then he grabbed my throat and he looked at me and he was like, I was like, whoa. I was like, damn. I feel like it was kind of intense for a first kiss. Like, that was my first kiss ever. And we were, like, sitting there, like, making out for, like, I swear, like, 10 minutes. Like, that shit was kind of crazy now that I think back at it. Or now that I think back at it, that it was, like, on the soccer field. Like, that's kind of weird. That was kind of weird. Kind of fun, kind of weird. Anyway, so that's my first kiss story time. I feel like I already told that. I definitely feel like I already did. Like, I had to have. But if you haven't heard it, there you go. I'm almost done with my eyebrows. It's taking light years, like. Oh my gosh, y'all, I got another parking ticket the other day. Are you kidding me? So basically, there's a residence lot, and then there's a reserved lot in the residence lot, and then there's a reserved lot right outside my house. The first ticket was right outside my apartment. I don't have that parking right there, so I got a ticket. And then the second time was the reserved in the residence lot. I didn't think there was another reserved lot in there because it was just one big lot. Pay attention to signs. If you're in college, pay attention to the damn signs because that's where they'll get you. So I wasn't looking and then I go to my car the next day, ticket. I'm like, can I ever do things right here? share some college tips. I know it's like literally already like y'all are in college if you are a freshman right now, but I'm gonna just share some of my tips because why the fuck not? Do on the educational side of things, because like I'm not saying who cares about the educational side of things in college, but when most people be given tips, it's like about everything but that, I feel like. So like my number one tip would be is to get to know your professors, because like, and your advisor, you know, especially your professors in your major, in your major classes, because when I tell you that'll help you so much more in the long run, when it comes to if you have to miss something or you need a teacher recommendation, you know what I mean? To get recommendations for literal jobs when you graduate, like all that, like it is definitely recommended to fucking, you know, build a connection with them, establish a relationship, a bond, you know. Simple as like going up to them at the end of class and be like, hey, this is me, here, you know, I'm doing this, like this is my major, I'm really excited for the semester, like it's just really simple shit like that that will, like, the professor will look at you and be like, oh, okay, like she cares about her education, you know. And like I'm saying this tip now, like I'm even saying this tip to myself, because like I'm even still bad at doing it, like it's hard. I feel it, I don't know. I know it's scary, like the professor, it's a big new room, it's like new people, like more people, like there's a lot of people at the end of class waiting to talk to the professor, but no, it's worth it, you know, to wait, introduce yourself, or even go to class hour, go to study hall with them, like not study hall, the fucking like office hours, yeah. I think a lot of professors are doing like Zoom office hours now, which is nice. Definitely recommend doing that shit, because it will change your grade, bro. If you're active listening, participating, if you have questions, you email, like, unless it's a weird ass class, you should be able to pass it better, you know what I mean? I don't know if I'm digging the eyebrows today, they kind of look weird. I don't know, I just realized how wide my eyebrows are and I'm like they're so thick, but I love them, okay? Even though I look crazy, I like my thick eyebrows. It makes me be. Yeah, I've tried the thin eyebrow thing. I did it in middle school. I've obviously changed since middle school. But when I was in middle school, my eyebrows were just so bushy growing up. So when I was in middle school, I was like, I need some kind of shape. So I got tweezers and I gave myself a whole new eyebrow shape. I don't know, y'all probably don't remember that, but that shit was fucking crazy. Like I made an arch out of nothing because I didn't have an arch before. I still really have that big of an arch, but before I had like no arch at all, and I was like, I took my tweezers and I cut this huge arch and I tweezed a bunch of my unibrow. I almost went too far. It was just bad. It was bad. So yeah, I just added some brown. Then I'ma blend it out. Okay. I'ma just time lapse this part so I can focus. I'm just adding browns and I'm gonna do a darker brown. And then I'm gonna cut it with concealer and then I'll come back, okay? I need a break. This is the NYX Glitter in Crystal and the NYX Glitter Primer. I can't talk while I do this either, or I'm gonna fuck it up, so. No, this glitter is just gorgeous. I don't know if you can see it, but it's just so pretty. And I don't have no makeup wipes to wipe the glitter under it. I don't know what my plan is. And then I'm gonna go with this little like small brush and just refine the little edge around it to just make it pop. You see how that already like fixed so much? Oh, am I a makeup artist? Like, what the fuck? Do y'all see that fucking cut? This is the hard part. It's almost over, Kenzie. Makeup is a mental game. Okay. I just did eyeliner. How's it look, y'all? I haven't done eyeliner in a second. I feel like this eye look looks better far away. Let's not get to the logistics of it all, but it's already done. That's it. That's what it is. Take it or leave it. Oh my gosh, I forgot to put on primer. I haven't put on foundation yet, but I might just not put on primer. This might be a brown mascara. I'm always accidentally buying the wrong color. This is the L'Oreal Voluminous Mascara. Okay, now that's over with. That was the hardest thing in the world. Now I shall put on my foundation. So I'm using the IT Cosmetics foundation in Fair and Fairlight. I'm actually mixing two shades, and then I'm gonna use these e.l.f. Sunkissed Booster Drops. And I'm just gonna put a little bit in my foundation, just like one little drop. I haven't really used these in foundation yet, so we'll see how this goes. Is it gonna make me sun-kissed? Make me sun-kissed. My skin about to be screaming. Foundation 2 days in a row? Like, I actually don't wear makeup as much as you might think. If that makes any sense. Rarely wear makeup 2 days in a row. And when I do, I am tired. Use the Morphe setting spray just to give me something to blend. It's already 10:30 in the morning. I've been sitting here for how long filming this video? I feel like I started filming this video at like 8. I use the Wet n Wild Photo Focus Concealer in light, I think. Neutral. Like, what does that even mean? I was gonna cream contour, but that's all the way in the bathroom. I have like all my extra makeup in these drawers in the bathroom, man. I'm sorry, I've been so in the zone right now because I'm just trying to be done because I'm not. Now that my face is set, I'm gonna go in with, you know, Physician's Formula Butter Bronzer. And just bronze this bitch up because I'm looking pale. I'm gonna use just, you know, blush on my cheeks. And then bake a little bit, you know. Because we love to see that. So now that I'm baking, look at this skin, bro. Hello. So I'm gonna tell y'all about this little story, but y'all can't tell my parents, okay? And if you're my parents, don't watch, because we haven't told my parents yet. So, it was my sister's 21st birthday. She does not live in the same place that, like, my mom and my dad do, and where I lived this summer, obviously. So I decided to go down there for her birthday. It was right before something. It was right before we went to South Carolina. So I go down there for her birthday and she gets so drunk, just so drunk. And we decided to go to McDonald's. Cause like, I want a McDonald's, like we all want a McDonald's. Get in the car, my sister at first she was like, go, let's just take your car. And I was like, no, let's take yours. This is where the shit gets fucked up. Okay, so I was like, no, bro, let's just take yours, because like my car was full of my shit to move into college already. Cause I was going straight from South Carolina to here. So like, I was like, you wouldn't even be able to sit in the passenger seat. So I was like, let's just take your car. So we took her car, and her car is very old. It's just old. And the, well, my car is old too, but hers is just really broke down. And so we take her car, it has really bad muffler, and you can't see the speeding. Is it, how do you, the something, odometer, spit, I don't know. You can't see how fast you're going. You have to put, Kylie would have to put a flashlight on the fucking, like, dash thing to see all of everything. And I was just not paying attention. So I didn't, like, put the flash on there. And Kylie was drunk, so, like, she wasn't paying attention either. We get going. And the city that my sister lives in is, or at least by the college, like, that whole town is very slow. Like, it's 30 miles an hour. I mean, it's 30 miles an hour around my college, too. But the cops in her college, like, in her town are just, ugh. And it was really late night. It was, like, so, of course, all the cops would be out. It was, like, 2 a.m. Or something. And we were just driving to McDonald's. And I was going maybe like 45. I was going way too fast. I was going like 45, maybe 50. I was going way too fast. And I fucking, Kylie literally was saying, oh my God, you're going way too fast. Slow down. And then cop lights were like right behind us. We're like, ah, I was like, ding, ding, ding. Bruh, this YouTube playlist is everything. It's this guy just like vibing with dreads, like, and he's like a DJ. I love this shit. Anyways, so the lights fucking pop up, and Kylie was drunk, so when she's drunk, she's very emotional. So she was like, oh my God, man. I was like, calm down, calm down. Oh my God, because whenever I turned, so we saw the lights. So I was like, oh my God, where do I fucking turn? Because, like, I've never gotten pulled over before. So I was like, oh my God. And then we pull over, we park, and then she walks up. It's this, like, officer. It's this girl officer, and she's like, have you been drinking? And I was like, no, ma'am. And Kylie was like, I'm sorry, it's my 21st birthday. We just want to go to McDonald's. I'm like, we're not making this better for ourselves. So she's like, well, you were going fast. You have a really loud muffler. And then did you see how you hit the curb when you turned to pull over? Like, whenever they were, when I was like pulling into the street, I guess I hit the curb. Like, I didn't even know. I was, like, just so, like, scared. I wasn't, like, scared. I was just, like, never gotten pulled over before. So I was, like, nervous. So I, like, fucking hit the curb pulling in to the fucking street to pull over. And a flare, and she was like, can I have your insurance? And this is the kicker here. So my sister's insurance was actually expired, and we renewed it, and my dad gave me the card to give to my sister. Like, it was in my purse at her house. Like, I was supposed to give it to her, and I didn't. It was a little late. But if you looked it up, like, I have, like, there's insurance on the car. It was just stupid. So on the ticket, it's like failed proof of insurance and a loud muffler, not even speeding. So I'm like, maybe it is speeding too, but like, I have no idea. So I got pulled over all the way on the other side of fucking Colorado, and they gave me a court date, and I can't even pay it off. Like, normally you can just like pay the ticket, and I looked it up, and like, I can't even pay the ticket. Like, I have a court date, and I'm like, like, bitch. And what was funny, the lady like asked for my email. I don't know what the fuck. Like, I haven't got no emails. And then Kylie, at the end, she was like, can we still go to McDonald's? And she was like, yeah, I guess that's fine. And then we went to McDonald's. And then, like, it took forever for that lady to process our information and shit. And Kylie was, like, crying. She was like, oh, my God, you shouldn't have be getting pulled over for my muffler. And then I was like, yes, I know. She was like, oh, my God, I shouldn't be getting you in trouble. And then I was like, girl, like, this is not going to be the end of my life. Like, I'll be fine. So now I gotta go to fucking court at the end of September, and I'm like, I do not want to do that, like, at all. And I think they're a virtual court. So I tried calling them, like, last week, and I was like, hey, and they looked up my ticket, and they were like, well, your ticket's not in the system yet, and I was like, what the fuck? So, like, I'm gonna call them in the beginning of September and be like, so what can I do here? Because it's literally like a 6-7 hour drive to get to that fucking courthouse. And I'm like, I really can't pull that off on a Thursday. Like, I have class on Thursday. I mean, I could miss it for a court date, but, like, I don't want to. I do not want to drive all the way down there. I was looking up trains. I was like, that's like a 9 hour train trip. I was like, I just don't want to do that at all. Like, so I'm hoping that they'll let me do a virtual, but, like, I also feel like they won't let me. So I'm like, if I just tell them I have COVID or something, like, I don't know. I just do not want to drive all the way down there at the end of September for absolutely no reason. And then, like, my parents don't know. Oh my God, I really hope they aren't watching this right now. But my parents don't know, and they have my location. They're going to see me going to Greeley. They're going to see me at the courthouse. They're going to be like, I'm gonna be late. It's not even that big of a deal, but, like, our parents are gonna find out soon enough because the insurance is gonna go up. This song keeps playing and I'm in love with it. It's called Heaven by Pink Sweats. Oh my God. I was supposed to see Pink Sweats at the Hive Music Festival, but he didn't show up. Like, what the fuck, Pink Sweats? I was kind of excited to see him because I really like his songs. Like, I fuck with his vibe and everything. I was like, bro, I'm gonna film some TikToks. I haven't, like, filmed TikToks in a second. Well, I do. I film TikToks all the time. But, like, I haven't, like, thought about some good TikToks in a second. I'm gonna film some good ones. Please just let me pay it, but that's crazy. I would rather pay for a ticket than, like, literally just go and, like, have and, like, show them the insurance and just get it written off. Like, can't that happen? I actually have no fucking idea. Like, what are they gonna do? Just fine me? Like, I'm gonna go all the way to the courthouse for them to just fine me? Like, just fucking do it already then. Like, why do I have to go to court for it? Like, I hate how fast setting spray runs out. Like, it's kind of sickening and gross how fast setting spray runs out. Like, okay, maybe it runs out every couple months, but still, I'm like, what the fuck? I hate buying new makeup. That's probably one of my pet peeves. I love doing it, but, like, also just spending money on makeup just pisses me off sometimes. I don't know. I hope that makes sense. It is so expensive. Ugh. So, or NYX too. NYX is kind of getting expensive. Like, I'm out of this setting spray too. Bitch, you get used to the Morphe spray and then you spray the NYX spray. I'm like, that was intense. Because, like, this Morphe spray has such, like, a gentle, like, spray tip. And then the NYX one's like, I'm like, oh. Now I'm gonna do my freckles, my new favorite thing. This is the Lottie Freckle Tint. I think it's the lightest one. And we just go crazy, okay? So, I don't know if you can see the freckles, but I just used it all for it. I'm gonna use the Mauve NYX lip liner. This one's new. I normally use the natural, but I got this. I opened it. It kind of looks purple right now. It's the lipstick. I just love that color. That's like perfect. These Maven Beauty lipsticks, like, they're so moisturizing and just like they are matte. Like, they look, well, they have a bit of a shine, but like they're just so moisturizing. This is done. I need lip gloss. Let me put all this fucking makeup away. This is a mess. My hair yesterday. I don't know why. Like, yesterday I had so much motivation to just get ready. Ew. Maybe headbands just don't look right on me. I'll wash it. But, like, I literally just washed it. I'm gonna go do my bun or something with my hair. And then I'm gonna put some jewelry on or something. And then I'll come back on here, okay? So I'm back. I just did a little pony, you know? Simple little pony. And I wrapped a little piece around to try to do something. And then these little earrings. Just put on the matching pants that goes with this jacket. But like, in all reality, I'm about to change this outfit whenever I actually leave because it is way too hot. This set's from Fashion Nova. It's not off the shoulder. I just made it off the shoulder. Very cute. I like in my new belly piercing. I don't know if you can tell, but it's a heart now. It's like a heart little belly piercing. And then this necklace is from Shein. My earrings are from Fashion Nova. I don't know if my earrings go with this. But yeah, my whole forehead is exposed. I don't know how I'm digging the look, actually. Thank you guys for watching and my little jumpsuit. Y'all want to check out Scentbird? I'll put the links down below for y'all to check it out. They smell so good. And like, this fucking dispenser has a lot of like spray. It goes like, I'm like, ah. Yeah, I love you guys so much. Please hit that like button, subscribe, and I will see you guys in my next YouTube video. Peace out, Girl Scout.